This week, at Interior. History was made this week by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, which proposed the first ever removal of a fish from the endangered species list due to recovery efforts. The proposed delisting of this fish, the Oregon chub, follows an extraordinary 20-year partnership among the Fish and Wildlife Service, the Oregon Department of Fish and Wildlife, the Army Corps of Engineers, and private landowners. The Oregon chub is a small minnow found only in the Willamette River Basin, in floodplain habitats with little or no water flow. The chub was first listed as endangered in 1993, then reclassified as threatened in 2010. At one point, fewer than 1,000 fish were thought to remain. Today, the population stands at 150,000. Threats to the chub were mitigated over the years by restoring and acquiring habitat, by promoting natural water flows, and by conducting education and outreach for local landowners and residents. On the heels of President Obama's State of the Union address, Secretary Jewell this week led a roundtable with scientists on the impacts of climate change in the Pacific Northwest. At the University of Washington in Seattle, the Secretary highlighted Interior's role in the President's Climate Action Plan to reduce carbon pollution, move the economy toward clean energy sources, and prepare communities for a changing climate. The Secretary highlighted the need to work better together at the local, state, federal, and tribal levels to prepare our communities for the expected effects of climate change. She also reminded the group of the important role our next generation has to play by developing meaningful connections to the outdoors and sharing those experiences with families and friends to continue to raise awareness about the important and lasting benefits of a healthy outdoor world. The Climate Roundtable followed a visit to Mount Rainier, where National Park Service rangers and U.S. Geological Survey scientists demonstrated the impacts of receding glaciers and changing climates on the park's rivers, infrastructure, visitor access, and recreation opportunities, as well as impacts to surrounding neighborhoods. Secretary Jewell this week also announced a key step forward for an offshore wind project in Oregon, the first proposed for federal waters off the West Coast. The Secretary joined Oregon Governor John Kitzhaber and Bureau of Ocean Energy Management Director Tommy Beaudreau to announce that BOEM has given the green light for Principal Power Incorporated to submit a formal plan for a 30-megawatt project using floating wind turbine technology offshore Coos Bay. The Secretary says the innovative technology and its future application hold great promise along the West Coast and around the world to harness the power of renewable resources. And wrapping up the week, Secretary Jewell joined Chicago Mayor Rahm Emanuel for a tour of the Michelle Clark Academic Preparatory High School, which is a model for leveraging public-private partnerships to provide students with rigorous learning opportunities and accelerated pathways to college and a career. The visit follows President Obama's announcement earlier this week on major progress toward realizing the Connect Ed goal, designed to enrich K-12 education for every student in America. At the center of that program is a challenge to connect 99% of students to next-generation connectivity within 5 years as a foundation for a transformation in the classroom. And that's this week at Interior.